بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الخلق وأعز المرسلين حبيب إله العالمين أبي القاسم محمد. وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين. My dear brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين. عظم الله أجورنا وأجوركم بمصاب أبي عبد الله الحسين عليه السلام. We offer our condolences to the Imam of our time, Imam صاحب العصر والزمان, on the commemoration of the martyrdom of his holy grandfather. And we pray that he is amongst us in these nights and gatherings, inshallah. On behalf of Imam Hussein Islamic Center, I would like to welcome you all to the Muharram program of 2023. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us another year with the opportunity to attend the majalis of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And we pray that we are given the honor to raise our voices in commemorating the legacy of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam year after year. Inshallah, tonight's program would begin with the recitation of the Holy Quran, followed by Ziyarat Ashura. I would like to call on the stage Brother Hassan Dusti and Dr. Wahid Wakil al-Raya to bless and begin our evening with a loud salawat ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. حميم عين سين قاف. كذلك يوحي إليك وإلى الذين من قبلك الله العزيز الحكيم. له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وهو العلي العظيم. تكاد السماوات يتفطرن من فوقهن والملائكة يسبحون بحمد ربهم ويستغفرون لمن في الأرض ألا إن الله هو الغفور الرحيم. والذين اتخذوا من دونه أولياء الله حفيظ عليهم وما أنت عليهم بوكيل. وكذلك أوحينا إليك قرآنا عربيا لتنذر أم القرى ومن حولها وتنذر يوم الجمع لا ريب فيه. فريق في الجنة وفريق في السعير. ولو شاء الله لجعلهم أمة واحدة ولكن يدخل من يشاء في رحمته والظالمون ما لهم من ولي ولا نصير. أم اتخذوا من دونه أولياء فالله هو البلي وهو يحيي الموتى وهو على كل شيء قدير. وما اختلفتم فيه من شيء فحكمه إلى الله ذلكم الله ربي عليه توكلت وإليه أنيب. فاطر السماوات والأرض جعل لكم من أنفسكم أزواجا ومن الأنعام أزواجا يزرؤكم فيه ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. له مقاليد السماوات والأرض يبسط الرزق لمن يشاء ويقدر إنه بكل شيء عليم. شرع لكم من الدين ما وصى به نوحا والذي أوحينا إليك وما وصينا به إبراهيم وموسى وعيسى أن أقيموا الدين ولا تتفرقوا فيه. كبر على المشركين ما تدعوهم إليه الله يجتبي إليه من يشاء ويهدي إليه من ينيب. وما تفرقوا إلا من بعد ما جاءهم العلم بغيا بينهم ولولا كلمة سبقت من ربك إلى أجل مسمى لقضي بينهم وإن الذين أورثوا الكتاب من بعدهم لفي شك منه مريب. صدق الله العلي العظيم.
صلوات.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. أزور سيدي ومولاي ومعتمدي ورجائي زخري وزخيرتي في آخرتي ودنياي مولاي أبا عبد الله إصالة النفسي ونيابة والدي ووالد والدي وإخوتي وأخواتي وجيراني وأصدقائي ونيابة عن أهلي وعن المؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء والأموات. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله. السلام عليك يا ابن رسول الله. السلام عليك يا خيرة الله وابن خيرته. السلام عليك يا ابن أمير المؤمنين وابن سيد المسيحيين. السلام عليك يا ابن فاطمة سيدة نساء العالمين. السلام عليك يا سار الله وابن ساره والوتر الموتور. السلام عليك وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك. عليكم مني جميعا سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار. يا أبا عبد الله لقد عظمت الرزية وجلت وعظمت المصيبة بك علينا وعلى جميع أهل الإسلام، وجلت وعظمت مصيبتك في السماوات على جميع أهل السماوات، فلعن الله أمة نسست أساس الظلم والجور عليكم أهل البيت، ولعن الله أمة دفعتكم من مقامكم وأزالتكم من مراتبكم التي رتبكم الله فيها، ولعن الله أمة قتلتكم، ولعن الله الممهدين لهم بالتمكين من قتالكم، بريت إلى الله وإليكم منهم ومن أشيائهم وأتباعهم وأوليائهم. يا أبا عبد الله إني سلم لمن سالمكم وحرب لمن حاربكم إلى يوم القيامة، ولعن الله على زياد وعلى مروان، ولعن الله بني أمية قاطبة، ولعن الله ابن مرجان، ولعن الله عمر بن سعد، ولعن الله شمرا، ولعن الله شمرا، ولعن الله أمة أسرجت وأنجمت وتنقبت لقتالك بأبي أنت وأمي، لقد عظم مصابي بك، فأسأل الله الذي أكرم مقامك وأكرمني بك أن يرزقني طلب صالك مع إمام منصور من أهل بيت محمد صلى الله عليه وآله. اللهم اجعلني عندك وجيها بالحسين عليه السلام في الدنيا والآخرة. يا أبا عبد الله، يا أبا عبد الله، إني أتقرب إلى الله وإلى رسوله وإلى أمير المؤمنين وإلى فاطمة وإلى الحسن، وإليك بموالاتك وبالبراءة ممن قاتلك ونسب لك الحرب، وبالبراءة ممن أسس أساس الظلم والجور عليكم، وأبرأ إلى الله وإلى رسوله ممن أسس أساس ذلك وبنى عليه بنيانه وجرى في سلمه وجوره عليكم وعلى أشيائكم، بريت إلى الله وإليكم منهم، وأتغرب إلى الله ثم إليكم بمبالاتكم ومبالات وليكم، وبالبراءة من أعدائكم والناصبين لكم الحرب، وبالبراءة من أشيائهم وأتباعهم، إني سلم لمن سالمكم وحرب لمن حاربكم وبلي لمن والاكم وعدو لمن عاداكم، فاسأل الله الذي أكرمني بمعرفتكم ومعرفة أوليائكم ورزقني البراءة من أعدائكم أن يجعلني معكم في الدنيا والآخرة، وأن يثبتني عندكم قدم صدق في الدنيا والآخرة، وأسأله أن يبلغني المقام المحمود لكم عند الله، وأن يرزقني طلب ساري مع إمام هدى ظاهر ناطق بالحق منكم، وأسأل الله بحقكم وبالشأن الذي لكم عنده أن يؤتيني بمصاب بكم أفضل ما أن يؤتي مصابا بمصيبته. من يؤتي مصابا بمصيبته مصيبة معظمها وأعظم رزيتها في الإسلام وفي جميع السماوات والأرض. اللهم اجعلني في مقامي هذا ممن تناله منك صلوات ورحمة ومغفرة. اللهم اجعل محياي محيا محمد وآل محمد ومماتي ممات محمد وآل محمد. اللهم إن هذا يوم تبركت به بنو ميت وابن آكلة الأكباد اللعين ابن اللعين على لسانك ولسان نبيك صلى الله عليه وآله في كل موت وموقف وقف فيه نبيك صلى الله عليه وآله. اللهم لعن أبا سفيان ومعاوية ويزيد ابن معاوية عليهم منك اللعنة وبد العابدين. فهذا يوم فرحت به آل زياد وآل مروان بقتلهم الحسين صلوات الله عليه. اللهم فضائف عليهم اللعن منك والعظام العليم. اللهم إني أتقرب إليك في هذا اليوم وفي موقف هذا وأيام حياتي بالبراءة منهم واللعنة عليهم وبالموالاة لنبيك وآل نبيك عليه وعليهم السلام. اللهم لعن أول ظالم سلم حق محمد وآل محمد وآخر تابع له على ظالمك. اللهم لعن العصابة التي جاهدت الحسين وشايعت وبايعت وتابعت على قتله. اللهم لنهم جميعا. السلام عليك يا أبو عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك. عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار. بل جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين. اللهم خص أنت أول ظالم باللعن مني وابدأ به أولا ثم العن الثانية والثالثة والرابعة. اللهم العن يزيد خامسا والعن عبيد الله بن زياد وابن مرجانة وأمر بن سعد وشمرا وآل أبي سفيان وآل زياد وآل مروان إلى يوم القيامة. اللهم لك الحمد حمد الشاكرين لك على مصابهم. الحمد لله على عزيم رزيتي. اللهم ارزقني شفاعة الحسين يوم الورود وثبتني قدم صدق عندك مع الحسين وأصحاب الحسين الذين بذلوا وجهم دون الحسين عليه السلام. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجهم.
صلوا على محمد وآل محمد. Just a couple of quick reminders before we get to the next part of the program. Inshallah, on Saturday will be the 10th of Muharram, Yawm al-Ashir. The program will begin 10:30 a.m. with Ziyarat Ashura, Salat al-Dhuhr, and then after prayers, there will be the Majlis, inshallah. Lunch will also be served at the conclusion of the program. And another quick reminder that the pledge initiative to Imam Hussein Islamic Center in honor of the 72 Shuhada of Karbala, please reach out to Brother Ali Sharif for more information, or alternatively, you can scan the QR code that is available on the banners outside. Salu ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. I would now like to welcome Sister Manessa Durrani, who will then, and then Zach Alawi will follow her with some recitation of verses of poetry. Please recite aloud Salawat ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.
صلوات على محمد وآل محمد. My dearest brother Abbas, my stand bearer Abbas, Abbas, my brother Abbas, Abbas, my brother Abbas. I'll never understand how it felt to fall on that sand, on that land, on that red hot sand, without any hands. Your loss is such great pain, tears drop like the rain. Abbas, don't leave me alone, for you are my backbone. Without you, how can I cope? You were my only hope. Life's hard that now you've gone. Abbas, my back has broke. Hussein, remove the blood. Around my eyes they flood. For the last time I see the lovely face of thee. Abbas, I have a request before you meet the rest, before you leave this nest. To call me Ya Akhi, you have never said that to me. We've lost someone who's dear. Abbas is no more here. Your loss is so hard to bear. Clothes of grief I should wear. Surely you've passed the test. You are among the best. Remembering you is a must. On that day, help us. From Abbas we must learn. Now it is our turn. How to remove that nafs? How to clean ourselves? صلوات على محمد وآل محمد.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وآل طيبين الطاهرين. O Abbas, when your enemies risen and passes us by, we remember to get water for Bint al-Husayn, how hard you did try. On Ashura this alam fell, but we promise forever to hold it high. Till our death your name will always make us cry. When we want our wishes fulfilled, Ya Bab al-Hawaj, we ask, yet we feel so very shy. We raise our hands in prayers, you ask one whose hands were severed from his side. Ya Abbas, when I think of the arrow that pierced through your eye, and when you felt how Salkina started to weep and cry, and how Hussein ran, on his way he sees the first and second hand, then sees his brother lying in the sand. But tell me, Abbas, one thing I cannot understand. When you fell, how did you land? For we cushion our former beloved Abbas, but when you fell, you had no hands. A step your brother took, more and more pain. Hearing you say, Adrikni ya Hussein, Adrikni ya Hussein. and do not take me back to get what I did for you. O Abbas, without you, Sakina will be slapped and stripped of her veil. Hussein looks at where your lifeless body does lay. Hussein rises in grief and starts to say, looking towards Najaf, his eyes with dry tears filled. O Father Ali, my back is broken. My back is broken. My brother Abbas has been killed. In that moment of anguish, the air stood still. As the weight of Abbas' sacrifice sent a chilling thrill, his flag once held high, now fallen with grace, a symbol of loyalty etched in time's embrace. O Abbas, your courage unmatched, your spirit unbroken, even when faced with adversity, never a word spoken, you fought with valor, defending righteousness true. For the cause of Imam Hussein, the skies and earth knew. The arrow that pierced your eye, a painful blow. Yet you remained steadfast in the face of the foe. The pain you endured, unimaginable and immense. But your loyalty to this cause, never wavering, never tense. As you fell to the ground, your mission unfulfilled. The weight of sorrow upon your brother, he chilled. Hussein with anguish and grief by your side. His heart shatters as he witnessed your stride. He saw your lifeless body, your severed hands, the pain in his heart like shifting sands. But tell me, Abbas, in that moment so grim, how did you land when your hands couldn't cushion the whim? For we now forced seek way to soften the blow. But you, Abbas, with no hands, bore the pain flow. Except Hussein took, your absence pained him more. The words that directly your Hussein forever tore. صلوا على محمد وآل محمد.
على محمد وآل محمد. MashaAllah, Sister Manasa and Brother Zach, there's a hadith from Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salam who says, there is none who recites poetry about Hussein alayhi salam and weeps and makes others weeps by means of it, except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes paradise incumbent upon him and forgives his sins. Sallu ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. I would just like to go over some quick announcements for tonight, inshallah. Please keep your phones on silent throughout the program. Until further notice, sisters will be downstairs. However, they are welcome to sit upstairs if they like. Toilets are located outside for the brothers and upstairs for the sisters. Ensure no cars are parked illegally and that we are respecting our neighbors by not blocking their driveways. No loitering in reception, please. Please also sit as close to the front as possible to allow others arriving later in the program to have a place to sit. It would be highly appreciated that you prioritize the chairs for the elderly and those with medical conditions. Just a reminder of IHIC's usual weekly programs. Tuesday, Dua Tawassul. Thursday is Tafsir al-Quran and Dua Kumail, Friday prayers, Saturday school, and the Sunday youth program, where every second Sunday is the program for the young brothers, and every alternate Sunday is the program for the young sisters. The Friday prayers, Saturday school, and Sunday youth program will all continue throughout the first 11 days of Muharram. Please don't forget to use these nights to donate generously to help with the cost of maintenance of Imam Hussein Islamic Center. Donation buckets will be going around throughout the lecture where you can pay with card or cash. A reminder of the Jurisprudence and Fundamentals Part 2 series that is coming up on August the 8th with Sheikh Muhammad Mehdi. It begins on August the 8th and it will go on for 9 weeks with a cost of $270 per person, with the prerequisite that you have completed Jurisprudence and Fundamentals Part 1. The sisters program will be from 6:45 to 7:45 p.m. and the brothers will be from 8 until 9 p.m. Kindly, if parents can assist with their children by accompanying them throughout the program to minimize disruption and ensure our programs are run as effectively as possible. Also, ensure children are well looked after and accompanied to the bathroom with shoes. And an important reminder that during the lecture, there will be a class running upstairs for children aged 4 to 13. So if there's any children aged 4 to 13, please make your way up to benefit from that program, inshallah. Also, there's a 6:30 p.m. program for the youth as well before this program. So that is led by Brother Sayyid Muhammad Murtada and Hajj Imad Hammam. Another reminder for the day of Ashura, which is on Saturday, inshallah. It'll begin at 10:30 a.m. with Ziyarat Ashura and then Dhuhr prayers. And then will be the Maqtal after Salah. And lunch will be provided at the end of the program, inshallah. And another reminder about the pledge initiative by Imam Hussein Islamic Center in the honor of the 72 Shuhada of Karbala. For any information, please reach out to Brother Ali Sharif, or you can scan the QR code that's available on the banners outside, inshallah. Sallu ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said to Fatima Zahra alayhi salam, O Fatima, every eye shall be weeping on the day of judgment, except the eye which has shed tears over the tragedy of Hussein alayhi salam. For surely that eye shall be laughing and shall be given the glad tidings of the bounties and comforts of paradise. With that, I would like to call and welcome His Eminence and our esteemed scholar and mentor of our community, Sheikh Mansour Lighai, for the main lecture of this evening. Please recite three loud salawat ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.
الله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا وطبيب نفوسنا وحبيب قلوبنا أبي القاسم محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم لا سيما بقية الله روحي وأرواح العالمين لمقدمه الفداء اللهم لعن أول ظالم ظلم حق محمد وآل محمد وآخر تابع له على ذلك السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين وعلى عباس الحسين أحق الناس أن يبكى علي فتى أبكى الحسين بكربلاء صلوات Respected brothers and sisters, Azadaran, Assalamu alaikum jami'an wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi alladhi hadana lihada wa ma kunna linahtadiya lawla an hadana Allah. Alhamdulillah for the blessing of being able by the grace of God to attend the majalis of Abu Abdullah al-Hussein, the branches of the holy shrine of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us as the provision of taqwa, inshallah, for the day, that nothing other than the piety of the heart will avail us, inshallah. As I was listening to the presentation of the youngsters, the sister and the brother, mashallah, God is my witness in my heart. I was praying for them and having, inshallah, very successful life in dunya and akhirah. Jazahumullah khairah to their parents. Inshallah, we are going to have such more youngsters in the community. How pleasing it is, really. And mashallah, so well recited and presented the poetries, like what the brother mentioned. One verse that you recite for Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, the Prophet has promised a palace in paradise, unless it be knocked and burned or anything, la samakallah. Jazahumullah khairah, if I may ask, for the inshallah well-being, the spiritual well-being of all our youngsters in the community. Sallu ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. Just to quickly recap what we've been talking about, for those in case that have come, I can see some new faces. Alhamdulillah, it's so very pleasing to see some old faces as well. I saw, mashallah, Ayy Murtazavi walked in, and really it was very delightful to see him. Jazahumullah khairah, jazakumullah khairah jami'an. Just to quickly recap, we began with the intention. We said that the best intention that we can make for such majalis is the intention of proximity with God, nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we try to dissect the meaning of proximity with God, one suggested that was offered was that proximity with God, it means to adapt and apply as many as divine names and attributes as possible on us and making it as part of our lifestyle and to the extent that is possible for us. We began with the name of An-Nur because there is a surah named after that, there is an ayah named after that. We explained about the meaning of Nur. And then we try to explore how can we gain this Nur and how can we download this Nur, this light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be more and more illuminated, which means more and more becoming close to the Almighty God. Last night we spoke about the Nur of Islam and Iman. After the program, one of the sisters, she was asking that, Sheikh, so how can we deepen our Iman? And I said, sister, come tomorrow night, which is tonight, inshallah. So it's a series of talks, and if you put pieces of puzzle together, inshallah, it will make more sense by the end of the evening of Sham Ghariban. So the topic for tonight is about the first stage of developing and establishing Iman and the Nur of the Iman and the faith in ourselves. According to the words of Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, this first brick of Iman is referred to as Al-Haya, one of the very difficult words to translate it in English, because Al-Haya in Arabic has a positive connotation. But once you translate it in English, you have to understand it with context. Haya literally, that in Farsi and Urdu, they refer to it as sharm. Those who have a Farsi or Urdu background, they know what the sharm is. In English, sometimes it's translated to shame. Sometimes translated to shyness. Sometimes translated to modesty, depending on the context. So understanding in a positive connotation and a positive meaning. In a nutshell, by al-haya, what we are talking about is to be ashamed of sinning in the presence of God. Assuming, believing as a believer that I know that God is all-knowing, all-seeing, all-hearing, and therefore whatever that we do, good or evil, we are in the presence of God. And the one who really acknowledges that they are in the presence of God, they should be ashamed of sinning in the presence of God. Let me share with you a couple of PowerPoints that I have prepared with you. Inshallah, if I can find them. Here you go. Inshallah, you see them on the screen. This is the main reference that I have for tonight's talk from Imam Sadiq alayhi salam. In the beautiful book of Misbah al-Sharia, Lantern of the, Lantern of Religion, something like this, I think is translated. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam says, Al-Haya'u Nurun. So we are in quest of Nur. We are now learning tonight about another aspects of Nur. Al-Haya'u Nurun, Jawharuhu Sadrul Iman. See, again, I've written here Al-Haya because I was contemplating how can I translate it as one word, but I will explain it. What Imam here, he means by Al-Haya, apparently, he means to be, as I said, to be ashamed of sinning in the presence of God. So Imam says that this is a nur that will illuminate you and your life in dunya and akhirah. That its essence, the essence of haya, is the earliest stage of faith. And if you want to develop your iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you want to deepen your faith in Allah, the starting point is to start with the this trait, this character of a haya. Try to develop haya in yourself. Try to develop this shame and shyness and I don't know, this modesty, to be too modest to do certain things, to be ashamed of disobeying the Almighty God in His presence. And then the Imam goes further to explain what tafsiruhu and the interpretation of al-haya. It means to be careful at whatever monotheism and knowledge deny. When you come at the different T junctions of life, at work, family life, business, I don't know, uni, walking off the street, surfing on the net, wherever that you are, when you see that your knowledge about Islam and your knowledge about monotheism tells you that I'm not supposed to see this, I'm not supposed to say this, I'm not supposed to listen to this, I'm not supposed to do this, then at-tathabbut, it means refrain. Be careful. Don't do that. If you live this type of lifestyle and you work on yourself to develop it, you are developing al-haya, which in returns, it means you are deepening your iman, which means you are getting into proximity with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanallah, I will prove it to you that how timely this topic is. On the one hand, for Muharram, because here is what the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam is quoted to have said, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم لو كان الحياء صورة لكان الحسين. If الحياء could have been, here I translate it to modesty. If modesty could have been personified, if it would have an image, it would be personified in the personality of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. So for sure, attending the school of Abu Abdullah al-Hussein in the month of Muharram, we need to learn about this character, this trait of al-haya, and especially it is so timely, so timely. Please bear with me during this limited time that I have. I will just introduce the concept. I don't claim that I can thoroughly, obviously, cover it. In our series of practical Irfan many years ago, this hall will testify that I've been talking about this subject in quite a lengthy way. But in a nutshell, I will present it to you and you continue the rest of it. Lack of shame before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers and sisters, in one way begins from home. When parents sometimes they lie to each other right in front of the children, they are indirectly, their silent language is that I have no shame to lie in the presence of God. A Muslim girl, and I'm not talking about the extreme example, the obvious example is that she says I'm Muslim, but she is not practicing it with her appearance even. But sometimes the appearance looks like Muslim. She's wearing a scarf, but full on makeup. With her friends on any issue, you see that they're swearing, and you can't believe, how can this girl with hijabi girl is swearing like this? Astaghfirullah, does she know what she's talking about? What, no shame whatsoever. And take it further, she's talking to her girlfriends with no shame, talking about being a girlfriend. This is the, that's what I'm saying, that the topic is really so timely these days for all of us. I humbly request, I can see Dr. Abed Ali, Jazahullah Khaira, and all the madrasa, if it's not already there, my humble suggestion, please, the topic of al-haya is mandatory to be part of the school curriculum, Islamic schools and madrasa everywhere. Not just as a concept, as a giving them examples and training the kids from the very young age. Because brothers and sisters, secularism stands exactly against al-haya and shame. The more secularism prevails, as it is prevailing, unfortunately, the more shame disappears. Yes? And unfortunately, you live in a society that surroundings have desensitized you. Not only the girls, the boys. One of the brothers, somewhere, I don't want to mention where, so one of the brothers in one of the Western countries was talking to a sister and in an Islamic center and referred to her similar to, like, for example, imagine at the reception a sister was serving and he's telling her, sorry, doll. And I said, excuse me? What did you say? She's not your doll. She's your sister. You're not allowed Islamically even to call her with name. Girls, sometimes they have a nickname among themselves, but for you and I, brothers, she is not Fa. She's Fatima. She's sister Fatima. If her friends call her a nickname, it's between them. The same for the guys. But you see, because you live in a society that shame is disappearing so quickly because of secularism, people are desensitized. When you tell her that, sister, you're not supposed to dress, what's wrong with my dress? Sheikh, look at my friends, much worse than me. Why are you picking on me? Brother, you're not supposed to come to an Islamic center like this. Quran says, خُضُوا زِينَتَكُمْ عِنْدَ كُلَّ مَسْجِدٍ. When you go to the place of worship, dress more modestly. Look, wait for summer to come, and unfortunately, you see some brothers, the way, like he got off the bed and comes to the Islamic center to place of worship. We are not supposed to come like this. Parents are may promote this for next year. From now until next year, we have 1 year to prepare ourselves. Promote the dishtasha, long and loose dishtasha for the brothers, and abaya for the girls, for the ladies, that at least when we come to the place of worship, we dress more modestly, more Islamic than tracksuit and t-shirt. I don't know, very tight. And what do you want to show up with? And they don't notice it. The problem is that they even don't notice it. Once upon a time, youngsters, younger generation, ask your parents of my age, not even Muslims, even as Christian ladies, the elderly, and I've spoken with them, they say at our time, it was not like this. Today's girls, excuse me, not all of them, some have no shame, the way they dress, the way they, the jargon they use, the way they mingle with the opposite sex, no shame whatsoever. And they don't notice it, they don't realize it. In at my age, with an Arabic background, in those with Arabic background, the man was too embarrassed, and still the elder these are like this. He will never call his wife with the first name, Zainab, Ali, I don't know, with nickname. All my life living with my parents, wallah, I don't remember even once my dad called my mom with her first name. Never, ever. Her first name was intimate between her and her husband. That's it. That's how, like, modest they used to live, the older generation, who were more Islamic generation. But being mixed and assimilated in the secular society, the guy, and I'm talking about supposedly practicing, brothers and sisters, his wife is wearing the hijab at her wedding. But they, as soon as they are engaged or the wedding is done, Subhanallah, all the photos on his profile, on his Facebook and Insta, everywhere, hugging, kissing each other. Brother, what are you doing? Why are you displaying your wife? There is no air, there is no shame. No. And they don't notice it. You know why? Because they live in a society that everybody is like this. The same people that you see their dress is not modest in Sydney, when they fly and travel to Karbala for the ziyarah, why is it that on Arba'in, I was observing this, all the ladies walking throughout from Najaf to Karbala, almost no single lady you see with manto even, all with chador, with abaya, everything. Why? Because society has impacts on us. The peer pressure, the surroundings have impact on us. Once I saw one of the young boys with the funny haircut. You think that you choose the style of your haircut? Believe me, when you go shopping, so much of what we do, I'm not talking you as an individual, I'm making a general point. Unconsciously, our brain is wired based on the advertising, based on the fashion that is out there. So I thought that like his mom or his dad had cut his hair and there was a mistake because there was a cut on the side. I said, who's cut your hair like this? He said, Sheikh, it's a fashion now. Putting a Z, I don't know, something. What's going on here? So the topic for tonight, and that's what I'm saying, that there are many examples. The topic for tonight, brothers and sisters, is if you want to be close to Imam Hussein, who was the personification of Al-Haya, is that to live more of the life of being ashamed of doing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not be pleased with. Sallu ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. SubhanAllah. Just the introduction took 17 minutes. In the Quran, to give you a reference from the Quran, in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Surah Al-Qasas, I think, that their story, long story short, you know the background of their story. Moses goes, the young Moses, he's not a prophet yet. The young and very strong and energetic Moses goes to help these two girls who don't know, he doesn't know apparently who they are. They needed some assistance, help them and carries the water for them all the way to their farm. Quran doesn't mention this part of it. The Rawayat says that now he's walking with two young girls. Yes, but he says that I'm not going to walk behind you. You're supposedly my guide. I don't know the road and the way to your farm. But I'm not walking behind you because I'm not supposed to look at you, your back. I'm a guy. I know that even a prophet, I'm not supposed to look at the back of a girl, okay? So I walk ahead of you. You sisters, you girls, you give me signals. Tell me when I need to turn left or right. That's how they go towards the farm. Once they reach there, Moses is tired. He's sitting to relax and go back to his life. One of the girls, this part Quran narrates, one of the girls, one of the sisters, one of the daughters of Prophet Shu'aib comes to tell Moses that my dad is calling you and wants to talk to you to appreciate what you've done for us. Look at how Quran subhanAllah is describing the scene. فَجَاءَدْهُ إِحْدَاهُمَا تَمْشِي عَلَى اسْتِحْيَا قَالَتْ إِنَّ أَبِي يَدْعُوكَ. Quran says one of the two girls, one of the two sisters is walking towards Moses, strange man. تمشي على استحياء. Quran could have said that she's walking towards, but the Quran has a message in that, describes the way that this girl is walking. So sisters, your way of walking could be shameless or shameful, could be modest or immodest. The way that you talk could be modest or immodest. The way that you converse with an opposite sex could be modest or immodest. Allahu Akbar. The way you dress could be modest. Tamshi al-astihya could have two meanings. One, the way that she's walking, Quran is teaching us, see how modestly she walks. Sometimes walking, and this mash in Arabic, it means lifestyle. Yani the lifestyle is the lifestyle of someone who is modest. The crystallization of the modesty, obviously, because had the strongest faith and iman was the Holy Prophet. The Rawayat says, the Imams of Ahlul Bayt alayhimus salam says, the Holy Prophet was so modest, even in the way he converses with the men, let alone women, he was lowering his face. He was not coming to eye contact with them out of modesty, not disrespect. But in a secular society that you live, you are told that, why don't you look at me when you talk to me? And now, because they get offended, I compromise my values because I don't want to offend them. I'm especially talking about the staring at the young lady. You're not supposed to stare at her. Don't worry about what she tells you. Because, you know, first she tells you that you, why don't you look at me when you're talking to me? And I keep staring. And then if I don't shake hand with her, why don't you shake hand with me? You're a fundamentalist. And then why don't you kiss me? And then why don't you sit around the, I don't know, now we are having a business meeting. There is, why you are so fanatic? You don't need to drink, but there is a drink on the table. Where do you want to stop? If you want to go with what they want you to do, there is no stopping point. Now the company wants to have a rainbow. Now they have to, you know, we all dress them. Otherwise, they will be off. You see, there is no stopping point, my dear. You need to put your foot down and say that, look, why do I need to compromise to your wrong values? You need to learn my values. Sorry, mate, not can do. I cannot shake hand with you. In my religion, it's not acceptable. You need to understand and respect my values. As simple as this, confidence. Have confidence in your religion. So the Holy Prophet, in his conversation with men, even lowering his gaze, Allahumma salli salawat. I mentioned the poem that Farazdak has for Imam Zainul Abidin. Sallu ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Yes.
يقضي حياءً ويقضى من مهابته فما يكلم إلا حين يبتسم. This is about Imam Zain al-Abidin عليه السلام. But Imam Zain al-Abidin represents the Holy Prophet as well. يقضي حياءً يعني he lowers his gaze out of modesty, not being disrespectful. Has smile on the face, so receiving, so nice, but out of modesty, lowering the gaze. At least when we speak to our Muslim sisters, don't stare at them. Don't use nickname when you are conversing with them, you see? So this is the nur of haya that Islam is telling us. You need to develop it within yourself. Imam Ali alayhi salam says that iman and haya, faith and modesty, shame, whatever you want to call it, they are so interwoven that they, you can use them interchangeably. لا إيمان لمن لا حياء له. The one has no shame, has no faith, and go out and you can see that. The less faithful, the less believing person, the less shameful, huh? Those who are shameless, you find them more among people of no faith whatsoever, isn't it? On the other hand, Imam Ali alayhi salam says that so لا إيمان لمن لا حياء له ولا حياء لمن لا إيمان له. As I said, interchangeably. And there is no shame for those who have no iman. There is no iman for those who have no shame. You want iman? Work on your haya to be as modest as possible. Girls especially, females by nature, they are more modest and they have more haya, supposed to have. And this is subhanAllah, a defense mechanism Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made in them. Some years ago, I don't know, still we have this type of, inshallah, of course we do, inshallah, we don't lose these values. So many years ago, maybe this is about 2 decades back, when we used to go for the retreat and the camp, sometimes we are running like competitions, and some of the sisters were saying that young teenage girls, she said that, Sheikh, I don't feel comfortable to come and answer the question in front of the guys. It's a virtue. It's good. You know, this is a protecting system for the girls. It's good. Girls who are shameless are more in a dangerous situation. And that's why al-haya and al-iffa, modesty, again, they are interwoven together. If you want to protect yourself, modesty is a virtue and is good. In the Quran, we have this story, and Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam mentions that part of it. You know the story of Prophet Yusuf ala nabiyyina wa alayhi salam. Again, long story short, when Zulaykha trapped Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam in her chamber and wanted to do what she wanted to do. She was an idol worshiper. Yes, she had a statue of her idol on the shelf. Now, before she lies down on her bed, she looks at her idol, supposedly her God, and puts a cloth on it. Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam takes advantage of that to wake her up. And he turns around and says, that, what did you do? And she goes, you know, this is my God. And I don't feel comfortable. He's looking at us. Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam says that Amat atastahina min alladhi la yasma'u wa la yubsir. You are ashamed of a statue that cannot see, cannot understand, nothing. And you don't want me to be ashamed of our creator? Where is your common sense? Where is your common sense? May I mention this? Talking in a counseling session with a young lady, she was telling me that I was chatting with someone with my, I don't know, I don't want to mention the name, not the name, yeah, like boyfriend or something. And the photo of my father was on the shelf. And all of a sudden, I saw my dad's photo, the family photo. My dad is in the photo. It's only a photo, not real. And she said, I turned the frame because I felt uncomfortable. My dad is talking, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. And we call ourselves Muslim. That's why Imam Sadiq alayhi salam says the first stage of iman, you want to develop iman in your kids, parents, teach them, train them to be modest, train them to be ashamed of sinning in the presence of God. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says yastaghfuna. I really feel that, may God forgive me for this expression, I feel that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us this with like pit. Look, and they call themselves Muslims. يَسْتَخْفُونَ مِنَ النَّاسِ وَلَا يَسْتَخْفُونَ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَهُوَ مَعْهُمْ. Quran says that in Surah An-Nisa, they try to hide it. They are ashamed of doing certain things in front of even a six-year-old boy. But they are not ashamed of doing it in presence of God. And while God is with them, they try to hide it from people, but they don't care about hiding it, which is impossible. وَهُوَ مَعَهُمْ And he's with them. Teach your children and ourselves. In theoretical Irfan, there is a branch called Ilmul Qurb. Ilmul Qurb, it means the science of learning about the nearness of God. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is nearer to us than jugular vein. A new revert, a new Muslim. You know, sometimes, wallah, God is my witness. I really envy some of these new Muslim sisters or brothers. I don't know how God opens their hearts for Islam. They go ahead of us, born supposedly Muslims. A new revert comes to the Prophet and says, Ya Rasulullah, I have slipped and committed a sin and I'm so regretful. Remorse, I hate myself. Is there any chance for repentance? The Holy Prophet recited an ayah in Surah Shura, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, wa huwa alladhi yaqbalu tawbata an ibadi wa ya'fu an as-sayyi'at wa ya'lamu ma taf'alun. The man said, Ya Rasulullah, can you please repeat the ayah? To save the time, I repeat it with translation. The translation is the following. The Prophet says that God that you believe in and you worship is the one who accepts the repentance and erases and forgives the evil deeds, and he knows what you are doing. The man says, Ya Rasulallah, he knows what we are doing, meaning that when I was doing that silly things, God was watching me. The Prophet says, what type of question is that? Of course he was watching you. When two guys, there a guy, I don't know, are in the car, darkness of the night, at the beach, somewhere, guy is the third one. This ayah of the Quran, وَهُوَ ثَالِثُهُمْ مَا نَجْوَى مِنْ ثَلَاثَةٍ وَهُوَ رَابِعُهُمْ There is no such thing as privacy. And then Quran says that, and yet they call themselves Muslims. وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ I think if I would say, if I could, أَسْتَغْفِرُ سُبْحَانَكَ يَا رَبْ If I could say, I would say that God is crying. And they're saying that, and I'm supposedly your Lord, huh? I'm supposedly your God. وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ They don't give due respect to their creator as the respect they give to an ordinary human. Wallah, she will not do that if her father would see her. He would not talk to that lady if his wife would see her. And the list goes on. Quran says, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ They don't give due respect to their Lord. And the Rawayat says, I think from Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, that استحيوا من الله كما تستحيون من الناس at least the respect that you give to people. Imagine someone respectful is watching us. No way we would do what we are doing. No way we would do that. So God says that at least the respect that you give to your fellow humans, give it to me. Haya has a very long story to share with you. With this limited time, I don't want to especially online prolong the session, but the first step of haya still is good, is that if I have a shame to do what I'm not supposed to do when somebody is watching me, even though this is not the best way to refrain and from a sin, but still whatever that keeps us away from sin, sin and being sinful is a virtue. It's fine. That now that somebody is watching me, no way I can do that. And you know the shame that I would feel, La Samahallah, if I have done something that somebody had seen. Now, even if this person is such a modest, very dignified person and never showed it to me, never spoke about it and let it go, and he knows that I have repented from it, I'm no longer in that bad habit and that bad sin. But still, every time I see him, I feel ashamed. I feel embarrassed, isn't it? I hope you'd have an experience that. We are all on the same boat, more or less. Different sins, but on the same boat. So one meaning of shame, one type of shame is that to be ashamed, don't live a life that you'll be ashamed of your wife. You'll be ashamed of your husband. You'll be ashamed of your parents, friends, and others. Keep your dignity. Amirul Mu'mineen says, those who want to maintain their dignity, they act more modest. They have the haya. But the best level of al-haya is that to be ashamed of the, because God is watching me. Because I am in the presence of God. remind yourself, if I get a chance tomorrow, I elaborate more on this, that repeat this dhikr for yourself. وَهُوَ مَعَكُمْ أَيْنَ مَا كُنْتُمْ. Wherever you are, however you live, whatever you say, no matter, nobody is there. Me, myself, and I only in my bedroom with my mobile. No single soul supposedly is around. Yes? Quran says no. Sorry, that's not true. First of all, God is with you. God is watching you. Second of all, the finger that you are using on your mobile, the tip of your fingers are going to testify against or for you. If you are watching a majlis, good things on the net, testify for you. If God forbid you are surfing on the wrong places, testify against you and I. And on the judgment day, you will be surprised. Wow, the tip of my fingers are talking. How can you talk? They say, أَنْتَغَنَ الَّذِي أَنْتَغَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ أَنْتَغَنَ اللَّهُ الَّذِي أَنْتَغَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ وَقَالُوا لِجُلُودِهِمْ لِمَا شَهِدْتُمْ عَلَيْنَا. Why do you testify against us? The skin, shook hand, hug, kiss, the lips are going to testify against the lips that have been used in, for the wrong reason. And when the person, the owner supposedly of the lips is going to complain, say, hey, you're my lips. What are you talking about? The lips turn and on say that the same creator who enabled you to talk made me talk against you and I have to testify against you. The earth where we the piece of land with the sin was committed, يَوْمَ إِذَنْ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا بِأَنَّ رَبَّكَ أَوْحَى لَهَا. That piece of land is going to testify. And the list goes on. Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam are eyewitnessing to us. But let me take you to Karbala with the good news. In an authentic hadith, Imam Sadiq alayhi salam says that those who are witnessing us are not only witnessing the evil deeds. Subhanallah. In the tafsir of the Akumela, I had mentioned this some years ago, that we have riwayat, and every time I remember this hadith, I'm filled with hope. Say, Ya Rab, inshallah, this applies to me. The riwayat says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, due to his infinite mercy, sometimes conceals our mortal sins, even from the Holy Prophet, to give us an opportunity, whether I make a U-turn, I regret, repent, or not. If I regret and repent soon, nobody knows. God has concealed it and let it go. We'll wash it away. But if I dare doing it again and again and again, then naturally I will be exposed. Normally, exposure to the sin doesn't happen for the first time. But once the person has the audacity to continue, unfortunately, and this is also a deterring factor to wake the person up, God removes the curtain a little bit. Let us repent before that happens. But as I said, the good news is that Ahlul Bayt alayhimus salam watch the good news and the good deeds of us sometimes as well. Imam Sadiq salamullah alayhi, he says, "Inna al-Husayn alayhi salam la'an yamin al-arsh." Tonight, the night of Abul Fadl al-Abbas, Imam Hussein alayhi salam, according to the words of Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, Imam Hussein alayhi salam is sitting on the right side of the throne of the Almighty God. وَإِنَّهُ لَيَنُضُرُ إِلَىٰ مَنْ يَبْكِينَ. And he's looking at those that during the majlis, they are weeping, they are crying, their hearts are broken for his uncle Abul Fadl Abbas. And for his brother Abul Fadl Abbas, Imam Hussein alayhi salam, إِنَّهُ لَيَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ مَنْ يَبْكِي فَيَسْتَغْفِرُ لَهُ. Allahu Akbar. What else do you want? You're sitting in the majlis of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Imagine from the corner of your eye that from the top floor, Imam Hussein alayhi salam is looking at you. And you are reciting, you are crying, you are serving. And Imam Hussein, as you are seated here, Imam Hussein alayhi salam, inshallah, is praying for our forgiveness with salawat ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad.
یادم ز وفای اشجع الناس آید و از چشم ترم سوده الماس آید. احق الناس ان یبکا علی فتن ابکی الحسین بکربلا.
آید به جهان اگر حسین دگری هیهات برادری چو عباس آید. مرحوم شیخ جعفر مشهدی اعلی الله مقامه, he was saying that whoever recites these two verses of a poem about Abu al-Fadl Abbas, Imam al-Zaman Jalla Allah Farajul Sharif would love it so much, attends and pays attention to that majlis. I began my majlis with these two verses in the hope that Sahib al-Asr wa al-Zaman, A'zama Allah ujuraka ya Sahib al-Zaman, tonight pays attention to us with his mercy, inshallah. Tonight, inshallah, Imam Zaman prays for us and for our offspring, inshallah. Tonight, brothers and sisters, we want to plead to the Almighty God in honor of Bab al-Hawa'ij ilallah, Qamar Bani Hashim, Abul Fadl al-Abbas. Send your souls to Karbala, Bu'd Manzil, نبود در سفر روحانی. As I recite the majlis, try to imagine the scene like as if you were there, even though I know it's traumatizing. Try to remember all your hawa'ij and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in honor of Abul Fadl al-Abbas. As-salamu ala al-Abbas ibn amir al-mu'minin al-muwasi akhahu binafsi المقطوعة يداها لعن الله قاتلي يزيد بن الرقاد وحكيم بن الطفيل. Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam says, إِنَّ لِعَمِّيَ الْعَبَّاسِ مَنْزِلَةً عِنْدَ اللَّهِ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى يَغْبِتُهُ بِهَا جَمِيعُ الشُّهَدَى يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. My uncle Abbas has such a sublime and high status with the Almighty God in the hereafter that all the martyrs will envy him and wish that they had that status with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the night of Ashura, we may inshallah touch on it on the night of Ashura. On the night of Ashura, Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas was the very first person who stood up with no hesitation to express his loyalty to his brother, to his master, to his Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Despite the fact that there earlier that day, on the day of Tasu'a, Shamr al-La'in had provided him amnesty, that you are maternally related to me. You come over, I let you go, nothing will happen to you. And Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas said, shame on you, as if I'm going to leave and abandon my master. Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas, before I mention his tragedy, allow me to, because normally his brothers are not mentioned, allow me to acknowledge the martyrdom and the bravery of his brothers. From his mother, Umm al-Banin, there were four brothers. Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas was the oldest one, who was in his 30s, to my research. Then after Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas, the second oldest one, his name is Abdullah, who is 25. Then the third oldest one is Uthman. Amir al-Mu'mineen, don't say why Amir al-Mu'mineen names his son Uthman. Amir al-Mu'mineen says that I named my son Uthman after Uthman ibn Maz'un, one of the eminent companions of the Prophet. Those oppressors, they didn't own those names. Let us remember that. So the second brother of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas, who was martyred in Karbala, his name is Uthman, who was 21. And the youngest one, his name is Ja'far, around 19. You can imagine that all young teenagers and young, all the three younger brothers, they sacrificed their life. They did not let the older brother to go further and fight. But on the day of Ashura, imagine that all the companions already have been martyred. All the Bani Hashim have been martyred. It's only Abu Abdullah al-Hussein on the one side of the wing of the front line, and on the other side we have Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas. The two lions of Allah are fighting against the enemy and signaling each other to let each other that they are still alive. At the same time, imagine, brothers and sisters, there is no water in the tents and in the back. And the kids and the ladies are crying, Al-Atash, Al-Atash, thirst, thirst. Uncle, I'm dying of thirst. Imam Ali ibn Musa Rida alayhi salam says that if the battle on Karbala and Ashura had continued in few hours, if it had lasted longer, most of, if not all, these kids, boys and girls would have died out of the thirst. Yes? Imam Hussein alayhi salam got close to his brother Abul Fadl Abbas and says, brother, you hear the painful cry of the kids. Please try for the last time, endeavor to get them some water. Abul Fadl Abbas goes back to the tents. They had dedicated a tent. They called it that this is like what they call it, Baytul Qirba. Yani this is the tent that they used to keep all the water skins there. He goes there to grab a skin water, but the water skin, but subhanAllah, the scene that Abul Fadl Abbas saw burst him into tears. What did he see? Because children were so thirsty. The only thing that Lady Zainab could do was to take the kids to that tent, remove all the skin waters, and ask the kids to pull off their shirt. And they were lying down on their chest on the sand of the on the ground of the tent, so that they can a little bit look cool off the body and their face. Abul Fadl Abbas grabbed, I don't know, one or how many water skins. And the narrator says that the Maqtal, this is how the Maqtal continues. فَرَكَبَ فَرَسَ وَأَخَدَ رُمْحَهُ وَالْقِرْبَ وَقَصَدَ نَحْوَ الْفُرَاطِ. Abul Fadl Abbas jumped on the horse with one hand holding his spear, with another one holding on the water skin on his shoulder. وَقَصَدَ نَحْوَ الْفُرَاطِ. His only aim is to reach the river. فأخاف به أربعة آلاف ممن كانوا موكلين بالفرات. 4,000 horsemen had surrounded the river. Umar ibn Sa'd had told them before the battle begins, under no circumstances you are allowed to leave your place, because I don't want any of the army of Hussein to reach the river. So you can imagine 4,000 shooters are targeting one target. وَرَمَوْهُ بِالنِّبَالِ. They shot him with their arrows. One of the enemy severed the right arm of Abul Fadl Abbas. This is where Abbas says, Wallah, in qata'tumu yamini, inni uhami abadan andini. By Allah, if you summon and pitch up my right arm, still I'm going to continue fighting the religion of my grandfather. They kept shooting him from all corners. An arrow pierced through, Ya Allah, Ya Allah. أعظم الله أجورك يا صاحب الزمان. An arrow pierced through the eyes of Abul Fadl Abbas and blood gushed out. On قدر بارید بر وی تیر تیز. I mash bar وی عشق ریز. Allahu Akbar, he fell on the horse. He could not fight anymore. He cannot see anymore because blood has covered his eyes. An enemy severed his left arm as well. And Abul Fadl Abbas could not stand on the horse, especially one of the enemy hit him on the head with a mace. Abbas fell off the horse armless. Let me explain this part of the Maqtal, brothers and sisters. If you fall down, naturally you bring your hands to protect your face. But imagine you are falling down armless. That's how Abul Fadl Abbas fell on the ground of Karbala. He painfully cried out, Ya Akha, Adrek Akha. This is the moment they have written Imam Hussein alayhi salam, like a fighting falcon reaches brother, but which brother? Body cut into the pieces. And that's why holding his back he cried, Al-an inkasara dhahri wa qallat hilati. وسيعلم الذين ظلموا آل محمد أيام قلبين ينقلبون.
عباس ويا فلسطين عباس There is Ali on al-Asghar. crying for water. There is Ruqayya crying for water. Oh, uncle, why don't you get us some water? Yeah, some water to quench our thirst. Yes. Oh, Zainab, Abu al-Fadayl, our uncle is taking so long. Has anything happened to him? We can't hear a sound but of Hussein with his core. Now my back has been broken. Tonight is the night of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas, Qamar Bani Hashim, Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas. Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas has reached the stage where it's just him and Hussein left. Al-Qasim is gone, Ali al-Akbar has left. And now the cries of the children are becoming louder and louder. The uncle of Abu al-Fadl Abbas, Shimr, would have already tried to get them to turn on Aba Abdullah. When Abbas would approach Hussein, seeing that there is no one left, he would say to Hussein, "Do you permit me to go to the battlefield?" To which Hussein would reply, "My dear brother, you are my standard bearer, and if you leave me, my army shall scatter." Abbas would then say, "My heart is becoming narrow, and I am greatly satisfied with my life, and I desire to avenge the blood of my brothers from these hypocrites. Then go and get some water from the children." Abbas would go to the enemy. He would return to the tent to get a water skin. Imagine he's walking past the tent. All he hears the children saying, "Ammu Abbas, Al-Ataya, Ammu Abbas, we are thirsty. Can you get us some water? Ya Amma, la tinsa al-wa'ad. Ana al-aziz askena. ذاب الأشفاق من الذمة جيب الحذب وروينا. اتقلنا يا عباس القمر وخلت ايديها بجفة. ارجع يا راعي المرجلة حالتنا صعبة وكلفة. He would go down to the battlefield. He would go towards the Euphrates with one mission, to get some water for the children. There were 4,000 enemies guarding the Euphrates. Abbas would begin to fight so courageously. Let's look at these brothers and sisters. Put our heads down. Imagine the situation. One step he takes forward, 10 steps they would take back. This is the resemblance of Ali ibn Abi Talib. He would break through. Reaching the Furat, he would dismount his horse into the river. As the thirst began to empower him, he would put his hand in the water. He would pick up a handful of water to drink. He would look down at that cool handful of water, and he would say to himself, are you really going to drink this water? When Abu Abdullah and the children are thirsty, ya nafs min ba'd al-Husayn huni wa ba'dahu la kunt aw takuni. You are drinking cool water, and Abu Abdullah is at the tent. He would feel his water skin. He would begin to make his way back towards the tent. Umar ibn Sa'd would call, cut his path, for if the water reaches Hussein, consider it to be the end of your lives. He would make his way through the palm trees. Then a man by the name of Zayd ibn Warqa would hide behind the palm tree. And when Abbas would pass, he would strike Abbas on his right arm. His arm would fall on the ground. As he calls, wallahi in qata'tumu yamini, inni uhami abadan andi. By Allah, if you were to cut off my right hand, I would still defend my religion. Abbas would hold the sword in his left hand, continuously fighting. He kept fighting until he was exhausted. He would continue to make his way back towards the tent until a la'in by the name of Hakil ibn Tufail would hide behind the palm tree and strike the left arm of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas, chopping his hand off. He would continue to make his way to the tent. The enemies would attack him from all directions with the arrows. Then an arrow would hit the water skin. The water would spill on the floor. Then they would shoot an arrow into the eye of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas. Wa waylah wa Abbasa. Abbas ankhak latroh walak almay matroh. Abbas would stand there confused. No right, no left, no arm, no eye skin, no water skin. his eyes, both with blood. He can't even see. What is he going to do? He stood there confused until a man would approach him from behind and strike him on his head with a pole. رحم الله من نادى وعباسا وسيدا وقمرا. يا عباس would fall onto the floor saying, أخي أدركني. My dear brothers and sisters, we didn't forget the main point, that when a horse rider falls off his horse, he has his hands to when he hits the floor. But Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas would fall straight onto his face. Wa Abbas, wa Sayyida, he would fall, calling, Akhi, Adrikni. Hussein would rush to the battlefield, calling, where are you escaping to? As the enemies would free from him between his hands, where are you escaping to? And you have murdered my brother. He would attend to Abbas to find his arms have been cut off. The eyes of Abbas have been shot by an arrow. The qirba is on the floor. The water skin is on the floor. The raya, the flag of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas is on the floor, my dear brothers. In that moment, he would hear someone walking around his head, thinking it was an enemy going to sever his head. He would call, by Allah's right over you, leave me until my brother Hussein reaches me. For Hussein would say, Akhi Abbas, I am your dear Hussein. Abbas would take the head of Hussein into his lap, and Abbas would remove it. He would ask, why do you do this, my brother? He says, now I have you to put my head in your lap. But in 1 hour, what will happen to you? You have your lap in the hands of Shimer, your head in the lap of Shimer, as he is holding his dagger. Hussein would want to return Abbas to the tents. Abbas would ask Hussein, what do you intend on doing? Hussein says, I intend on taking you back to the tent. Abbas would say, by the right of Rasulullah over you, don't take me back to the tent. Leave me here on the floor. I can't bear to see Sakina in this state without water. I don't want her to see me. I am shy for her. Ya khuwa, ya Hussein, خليني بمكاني أجركم الله. And in this moment, Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas would leave this world. Abu Abdullah would stand up, wiping the tears off his face, saying, الآن انكسر ظهري. Now my back has been broken. He would call that in the loudest voice. He would go back to the tent, Abu Abdullah. And what would he do? He would see Zainab. She would come towards him. She would tell him, oh brother, you have come back alone without your partner. Where is my brother Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas? Oh my sister, عظم الله لك الأجر بأبو الفضل العباس. Zainab would not get the chance to go to the body at that time of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas. But when she would go, she would go down to the battlefield in her pain. They say that maybe on after, in the night, what could she say? What could she say to the body? Ya Abu al-Fadl, ya darbani بعد عينك يشتموني أهل دمع الفجيعة يا نايم على الشريعة من هود الليلة طلعت جيتك أسولف حالتي لما انتحت يا بالفضل طاحت يا خويا دمعتي وين انت وجهي والعدا حرقوا علي خيمتي لا ذا الاخو لا ذا الولي يحمي بعدكم عيلتي يا ابو فاضل انا بحيره ردت كافل يا ابو الغيره وساف شفقتي يا نايم على الشريعه يا ابو فاضل يا درباني بعد عينك يشتموني أهل دمع الفجيعة يا نايم على الشريعة عباس جيتك اشتكي عندي رسالة مؤلمة مكتوبة بدموع الهضم طفلة واسمها فاطمة تشرح معانا السلب من هالإذن تنزف دماء سلى بجاها وما رحم خد اليتيم الناعمة يا ابو فاضل لا توم خدها لو ان حاضر شنت عندها اهل دمع الفجيعة يا نايم على الشريعة. Brothers please stand and come forward. Let me يا ابو فاضل يا ذربوني بعد عينك يا شتموني اهل دمع
يا حسين ومصاب يا حسين ومصاب يا حسين يا حسين ومصاب
They can cut my arms and my legs. They can take everything that I have. I will come crawling to you, Hussein. I will come crawling to you, Hussein. On the plains of Karbala, when you said with a heart so scarred, Hal min nasir yansurna, who can help me in time so hard? Falling from the cot to the floor, Ali Azhar gave this call. I will come crawling to you, Hussein. I will come crawling to you, can cut my arms and my legs. They can take everything that I have. I will come crawling to you, Hossein. I will come crawling to you, Hossein. Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala. Mother, forgive me, for I no longer live, but I gave you nothing left there was to give. For brother Hossein, I gave my left and right. Oh, mother, for Hossein, I gave my eyesight. Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala. I gave my right, for I was his right hand man. When all left Hossein, with Hossein I would stand. I gave him my left, I promised to give all. I refused to see before me Hossein fall. Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala. With an arrow to my eye, I could still see, like Zainab, I still saw nothing but beauty. They rejoiced at my pain, but did they not know? For Hossein, on death itself, myself I throw. Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala. Ah, they hit me with a pole, my balance I lost. No arms to support from my horse, I was tossed. But mother, despite everything that they took, still to Master Hossein with guilt I would look. Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala. Oh, more I wanted to offer, I was not done. For me the battle hadn't even begun. But mother, forgive me, to me death had come. How could I leave when Hossein hadn't yet won? Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala. Oh, mother, though in my grave you have my support, continue my mission for which I had fought. Mother, for forgiveness I ask you again, for I departed and alone sent Hossein. Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala, ya Karbala, Karbala, ya Karbala,
ya Karbala, ya Karbala. شفت الشمس يمي النهار، شفت الشمس يمي النهار، محنية تبكي على القمر. شفت الشمس يمي النهار، محنية تبكي على القمر. شفت يمي النهار، محنية تبكي على القمر. بالمحنة مكسوفة شمس،
بالمحنة مكسوف الشمس طلعت من خيمة ويتحيس كان جمرة تلذع بالنفس كان جمرة تلذع بالنفس ومبرقي عب حاجب قيدا شفت الشمس يمي النهار محنية تبكي على القمر شفت الشمس يمي النهار جواب محنية تبكي على القمر بعد شفت الشمس يمي النهار محنيتك قمر صبت الرسول المصطفى صبت الرسول المصطفى بيا الشمس متوصفة صبت الرسول المصطفى بيا الشمس متوصفة تعنى ويذيب خطوة ويفة مصحوبة بمواج البصر راح وقصد للمشرعة راح وقصد للمشرعة لن شافوه وبمصرعة شاف نشوفه في مقطيعة شاف نشوفه في مقطيعة عيناني شابت القدر شفت الشمس يمي النهار محنية تبكي على شفت الشمس نهار محنية تبكي على القمر شفت الشمس يا تبكي على القمر صاح ودمع عينيه من ويا يريد يا بالفاضي بالخيمة تدريج كم طيفي بالخيمة تدريج كم طيفي من غيبتك حس بخطأ يا خويا يا نعم الأخو يا خويا يا نعم الأخو وانت ذخي رمني الأبو جتلك شمت بين العدو وانا انكسر مني الظهر شفت الشمس يمي النهار محنية تبكي على القمر شفت الشمس يمي النهار محنية تبكي على القمر شفت الشمس يمي النهار يا تبكي على القمر لن القمر صوت اعتيلة خلني يا بن عبد الويلة لن القمر صوت اعتيلة
خلني يا ابن عبد الويلة يا عاين أصيد عايلة والنب لما خلت النظر شلون أضيد لي عيلاتي لا يمنيتي ولا يسريتي سكنتي ناظر جيتي والتتروبة ظلت عثا شفت الشمس يم النهار محنية تبكي على القمر شفت الشمس يم النهار محنية تبكي على القمر شفت الشمس شفت الشمس محنية تبكي على القمر ناداها ابو اليمة بألم نصينا حس قلب جيسم بين الشريعة والخيم قلبي يا عباس شيطة قلبي يا عباس شيطة ما أدري يم جسمك أظل لو أرجع لصوب الأهل وين أمضي واني بلا أمل وين أمضي واني بلا أمل باصرني يا ضي البصر شفت الشمس يم النهار محنية القمر شفت الشمس يم النهار محنية على القمر مدد يا عباس مدد يا عباس مدد يا عباس مدد يا عباس بعد مدد يا عباس 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 أبو الغيرة منو غيرة أبو الغيرة منو غيرة رفع راية علي بجفه رفع راية علي بجفه أسد قسوار شبل حيدار إذا شفته علي تعرفه مثل عودة بكرم جودة مثل عودة بكرم جودة أبو فاضل علي كامل أبو فاضل علي كامل إذا بيد العلم رفه شهم ما مثله كريم بأصله شهم ما مثله كريم بأصله مدد يا عباس مدد يا عباس مدد مدد يا عباس يا عباس مدد مدد يا عباس مدد يا عباس مدد مدد يا عباس مدد يا عباس
مدد يا عباس مدد يا عباس
مدد يا عباس مدد يا عباس مدد يا عباس مدد يا عباس ورث جده وأخذ مجده ورث جده أخذ مجده شجاعة من أبو طالب شجاعة من أبو طالب أخذ حلمه إرث عمه أخذ حلمه إرث عمه
مثل جعفر ما رد طالب، مثل جعفر ما رد طالب، وأخذ عزة من الحمزة، أخذ عزة من الحمزة، صبح فارس بني غالب، صبح فارس بني غالب، ومثل حيدر غضب أحمر، مثل حيدر غضب أحمر، إلى روح العدو سالب، ورث أمجاده شبه أجداده، ورث أمجاده شبه أجداده. مدد يا عباس، مدد يا عباس، مدد، مدد يا عباس، مدد يا عباس، مدد، مدد يا عباس، مدد يا عباس، مدد يا عباس، مدد يا عباس. أسد عابس ابن فارس، أسد عابس ابن فارس، يجب وسط الحرب يزار، يجب وسط الحرب يزار، إذا ينزل تشوف الكل تفر من عيدها تقهقهار، إلا صارم صدق حازم، إلا صارم صدق حازم، إذا ينزل يقص منحار، على مهره يدق صدره، علي ماكو أحد يقدر، علي ماكو أحد يقدر، إذا سلسفه يدور كيفه، إذا سلسفه يدور كيفه. مدد يا عباس، مدد يا عباس، مدد، مدد يا عباس، 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 بعد مدد يا عباس، مدد يا عباس، عباس علي يحلي فضله كله، صبح حق الوفا آية، إذا أدهرك قصة بأمرك، تعال وقصت مشاية، يسر قلبك يسر دربك، ترد منه بالشكاية، يلبي لك يوفي لك، لأن جفوف وفايا، لأن جفوف وفايا، تعال وقصده حوائج عنده، تعال وقصده حوائج عنده. مدد يا عباس، مدد يا عباس، مدد يا عباس، عباس مدد يا عباس، 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 جواب مدد يا عباس، 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 مدد يا عباس. قطعوا يمين العباس يا فاطمة الحزينة، قطعوا يمين العباس يا قطعوا يمين العباس، قطعوا يمين العباس، قطعوا يمين العباس. للمشرع قوم بساع طلع بسهم من عينه، قطعوا يمين العباس يا فاطمة الحزينة، قطعوا يمين العباس يا فاطمة، قطعوا يمين العباس. للخيمة ما يرضى يعود يا فاطمة الحزينة، للخيمة ما يرضى يعود، خجلان من سكينة، للخيمة ما يرضى يعود، خجلان من سكينة، قطعوا يمين العباس، قطعوا يمين العباس، قطعوا يمين العباس، فوق انحنى ظهر حسين، فوق انحنى ظهر حسين، يقبل بجفينا. قطعوا يمين العباس، قطعوا يمين العباس، خيمتها زينب وتصيح وين الكفلنا وينه، خيمتها زينب وتصيح وين الكفيلة وينه. قطعوا يمين العباس يا فاطمة، قطعوا يمين العباس، قطعوا يمين العباس، قطعوا يمين العباس. ندري به غالي عباس هالخبرها، قطعوا يمين العباس يا فاطمة الحزينة، قطعوا يمين العباس، قطعوا يمين العباس يا فاطمة الحزينة، يا فاطمة الحزينة، قطعوا يمين العباس. يا عباس جيب الماي لسقينا، 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 يا عباس ماي لسقينا. عطش نار بالقلوب تجوينا، عطش نار بالقلوب تجوينا، يا عباس جيب الماي لسقينا، يا عباس، يا عباس جيب الماي لسقينا، يا عباس جيب الماي لسقينا. نتانيك بالخيام ظلينا، نتانيك بالخيام ظلينا، يا عباس جيب الماي لسقينا، يا عباس جيب الماي لسقينا، يا عباس جيب الماي لسقينا، يا عباس لسقينا، يا عباس شوف الحرام عطشانا، يا عباس شوف الحرام عطشانا، يا عباس جيب الماي لسقينا، يا عباس، يا عباس جيب الماي لسقينا، يا عباس جيب الماي لسقينا، يا عباس شوف الخيام حرقوه، يا عباس شوف الخيام حرقوه، يا عباس جيب الماي لسقينا، يا عباس، يا عباس هاي لسقينا، يا عباس هاي لسقينا، يا عباس رأس حسين بنيزه، يا عباس رأس حسين بنيزه، يا عباس جيب الماي لسقينا، يا عباس، يا عباس جيب الماي لسقينا، يا عباس شوف الحسين عطشانا، يا عباس شوف حسين عطشانا، يا عباس جيب الماي لسقينا، يا عباس جيب الماي لسقينا، يا عباس لسقينا، يا عباس بخيمها آتش زدان، يا عباس بخيمها آتش زدان، يا عباس غارت شد گوشواره ها، يا عباس سين زدان بدخترا يا عباس جيب الماء لسكينة جواب يا عباس جيب الماء لسكينة يا عباس جيب الماء لسكينة يا ابو فاضل دخيلك 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 يا ابو فاضل دخيلك
يا ابو فاضل دخيلك هيهات هيهات من نزل هيهات هيهات من نزل هيهات هيهات من نزل tonight's the night of Abbas there shouldn't be a soul in this building who's quiet من نزل الله هيهات 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 من نزل الله هيهات هيهات كل شخص للثاني ظل يحكي بلي كل شخص للثاني ظل يحكي بلي هذا مو عباس كان هذا علي علي مدفون راجع شلون علي مدفون راجع شلون احنا جينا كربلاء لول النجف احنا جينا كربلاء لول النجف بينا واد الموت كان مره نخسف عمل عيون راجع شلون هيهات هيهات من نزل Like Abbas shook the battlefield, we should shake these words with our mouth. Hayhat, hayhat, min nadillah. Hayhat, hayhat, min nadillah. Hayhat, hayhat, dillah. كل شخص للثاني ظل يحكي بلي كل شخص للثاني ظل يحكي بلي هذا مو عباس شن هذا علي علي مدفون راجع شلون علي مدفون راجع شلون احنا جينا كربلاء لول النجف احنا جينا كربلاء لول النجف بينا واد الموت شن مرة نخسف عم العيون راجع شلون هيهات هيهات من نزل هيهات هيهات من نزل هيهات والله إن قطعتم يميني والله إن قطعتم يميني إني أحامي أبدا عن ديني إني أحامي أبدا ديني والله إن قطعتم يميني والله إن قطعتم يميني إني أحامي أبدا عن ديني كلمة العباس ظلت خالدة كلمة العباس ظلت خالدة دوحة التاريخ تبقى موردة عالشجاعة والمبادئ شاهدة وقبل سفارة جفت قلب العدا كلمة العباس ظلت خالدة كلمة العباس ظلت خالدة دوحة التاريخ تبقى موردة عالشجاعة والمبادئ شاهدة وقبل سفارة جفت قلب العدا قول زها كناسع اللجيني قول زها كناسع اللجيني إني أحامي أبدا عن ديني إني صاف والله إن قطعتم يميني إني أحامي أبدا عن ديني والله إن قطعتم يميني والله إن قطعتم يميني إني أحامي أبدا عن ديني إني أحامي والد حيدر أسد وهو الشبل، والد حيدر أسد وهو الشبل، ومثل حيدر مبدأ قوله فعل، بيمن تاير بتبيصار يحل، والسعب من هيبته يصبح سهل. يا مهدي عجل على هيهات من مد الله. والد حيدر أسد وهو الشبل، والد حيدر أسد وهو الشبل، ومثل حيدر مبدأ قوله فعل، بالنتاير بتبيصار يحل، والصعب من هيبته يصبح سهل. قال بصوت صادق المبين، قال بصوت صادق المبين، إني أحامي أبدا عن ديني، إني أحامي أبدا عن ديني. والله صوت الله إن قطعتم يميني، حامي أبدا. والد حيدر أسد وهو الشبل، والد حيدر أسد وهو الشبل. حيدر يا علي يا مهدي عجل على هيهات من مد الله. والد حيدر أسد وهو الشبل، ومثل حيدر مبدأ قوله فعل، بالنتاير بتبيصار يحل، والصعب من هيبته يصبح سهل. قال بصوت صادق المبين، قال بصوت صادق المبين، إني أحامي أبدا عن ديني، إني دنا عن ديني. والله إن قطعتم، والله إن قطعتم يميني، إني يحامي أبدا عن ديني، إني يحامي أبدا عن ديني. قال لو تقطع يميني بهالسيوف، قال لو تقطع يمين بهالسيوف، قال لو تقطع يمين بهالسيوف، عالتراب ظلت رمية الجفوف، تبقى روح ساحة الحومة تتوف، ما أبيع الدين لحظة ما أقف، أي دمع الدين استقى معيني، أي دمع الدين استقى معيني، إني أحامي أبدا عن ديني، إني أبدا عن ديني. والله إن قطعتم يميني، والله ديني، إني أحامي أبدا عن ديني. والله إن قطعتم يميني، والله إن كلمة العباس ظلت خالدة، كلمة العباس ظلت خالدة، دوحة التاريخ تبقى موردة، الشجاعة والمباتن شاهدة، وقبر سفارة جفت قلب الحيدة. قول زها كناسع النجيني، قول زها كناسع النجيني، إني أحامي أبدا عن ديني، إني أحامي أبدا عن ديني. والله إن قطعتم يميني، والله إن قطعتم يميني، إني إني أحامي أبدا عن ديني. والله إن قطعتم يميني، والله إن قطعتم يميني، إني أحامي أبدا عن ديني، إني أحامي أبدا عن ديني. حسين 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 حسين. يا بالفضل لو صحت اهتز السماوات، يا بالفضل لو صحت بقلم احنا هيهات، يا بالفضل يا بالفضل يا بالفضل فاض، يا بالفضل لو صحت اهتز السماوات، يا بالفضل لو صحت بقلم احنا هيهات، يا بالفضل يا بالفضل يا بالفضل فاض. حسين سلطاني، حسين حسين سلطاني، دليل إيماني تحتل العنواني عشقتك اني عشقتك اني حسين سلطاني حسين سلطاني دليل ايماني تظل عنواني عشقتك اني عشقتك اني يا ابا الفضل لو صحت زينب تنغفر لي يا ابا الفضل لو صحت ذنبي تنغفر لي ابا الفضل يا ابا الفضل يا ابا الفضل فاض مجنونك اظل مجنونك حسين مجنونك اظل مجنونك انا ما اقدر اعيش بدونك اعيش بدونك حسين عين الله حسين وجه الله لفقدك ظهره حسين يا ويله حسين يا ويله يا ابا الفضل لو صحت افرح ام البنين يا ابا الفضل لو صحت يفرح قلب الحسين يا ابا الفضل يا ابا الفضل يا ابا الفضل يا ابا الفضل يا عباس شب الماي لسكينه يا عباس شب الماي لسكينه عباس شب الماي لسكينه يا عباس شب الماي لسكينه والله إن قطعت ما يميني يا عباس Why didn't you get the water for Sukaina? Ya Aba al-Fadl al-Abbas. Why is it that when we go to Karbala, we have to go to three places to visit you? We go to the place that your left hand would fire. We go to the place that your right hand would fall. Ya Abbas, did you see when they would slap Zainab on the face? When she would say, Wa akha, wa kafila, she was calling you on the 10th of Muharram, saying, Aina kafili, Aina Abbas. Ya Abbas, did you see when they ripped the earrings off Ruqayya? And she called Ya Amma. Did you see Sukaina? Did you hear Sukaina in her call? Ammo Jib El Mai, Ya Abbas, Jib El Mai Laskena, Ya Abbas, Jib El Mai Laskena, Ya Abbas, Jib El Mai Laskena, Ya Abbas, Jib El Mai Laskena. يا ابو فاضل دخيلك يا ابو فاضل دخيلك يا ابو فاضل دخيلك يا ابو فاضل دخيلك يا عباس جيب الماي لسكينة يا عباس جيب الماي لسكينة يا عباس جيب الماي لسكينة يا ابو فاضل دخيلك يا ابو فاضل يا ابو فاضل لا اله الا الله لا اله الا الله محمد الرسول الله لا اله الا الله عليا ولي الله عليا ولي الله عليا ولي الله نادى علي يا مظهر العجائب، نادى علي
يا مظهر
العجائب، تجده النوائب كل هم بعظمتك بنبوتك بولايتك علي 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 حيا على البكاء حيا على البكاء في ماتم الحسين مظلوم كربلاء سلطان كربلاء عطشان كربلاء سلطان كربلاء أين الطالب
بالمقتول بكربلاء أين الطالب
بالمقتول بكربلاء أين الطالب بدم المقتول بكربلاء اللهم كن حجة ابن الحسن صلواتك في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك دوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. Brothers and sisters, it's been a request that we recite Fatiha for Marhuma Haji Hayat Ali Sakir. If we can recite, if we can recite the Fatiha, but before it, Allah salawat ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.
Neighbors and keep as quiet as possible.